in Egyptian society,
yes,
not in politics. Look, the Egyptian military is secular military. The Turkish military is secular military. The Pakistan military is a military which has got jihad in its motto. The Americans support the Pakistan military. The Europeans oppose the Turkish military and help the AKP, which is a basically a religious party, to completely weaken and you know, almost terminally weaken the Turkish military. And the Americans are now, frankly, not at all helpful to the Egyptian military. The Russians are much more helpful, and therefore there's a transformational geopolitical shift going on. The fact of the matter is that the military in Egypt does not stand for radical values. It's against radical values. It does not stand for a Wahhabi state. It's against the Wahhabi state. It does not want a situation in which women cannot drive and women have got to wear a particular kind of dress, that everybody's got to eat a particular kind of food. It's a very different kind of military. But if you technically talk in terms of, you know, it's very easy for us to call the concept of democracy, non-democracy. There are shades and shades and shades of democracy and non-democracy, quite frankly. And the actual implementation of the administration of Mohammed Morsi was a steady Wahhabization of Egyptian society. The Muslim Brotherhood has never hidden the fact, and if you look at the Muslim Brotherhood's treatises, for example, right from the beginning, please read his treatises during the time when Mr. Mohammed Morsi was the president. It's vituperative against the Jews, against the Christians, against idol worshippers, you forget about it. You know. But against the Jews, against the Christians, they continue to be vituperative about them. They continue to be vituperative about people whom they believe are infidels, hypocrites. Anybody who is not a Wahhabi is a hypocrite. So even during the time when they had power, they did not change and say, we accept democracy. They made it very clear, we want this kind of a state. All their key leaders wrote essays that, look, don't worry, Egypt is like this now, but we are going to make it different. They said this in black and white, in Arabic, multiple times in interviews, in newspaper articles, in tracts, in pamphlets, hundreds of them. It was there, the good thing about them, they were completely transparent about it. And Mr. Morsi was transparent about it. There was no PR in Mr. Morsi. He was completely transparent about it. But what surprises me, frankly, the United States or European countries, they don't seem to be able to read Arabic or you know, or Urdu or anything. I mean, they're so obsessed with English that they don't want to read any other language. Because if they read Arabic, at least one American read Arabic, I'm sure nobody does, they would read this. You know? And when Morsi was in charge, the top leaders of the Brotherhood have said, this is only a wayside stop. Our goal is a Wahhabi state. And we are going to reach it, we are going to use this to the full, eliminate everybody else, and then reach that. So from that point of view, I would say, these are not the kind of people I would trust to run the situation in democracy. What is happening in Turkey is a creeping Wahhabization of society. Fortunately, there's a kind of a blowback, there's a fight back now, and Turkish society is fighting back against Mr. Erdogan. But for me, I look at on the ground, what kind of society do people want? And I got that training in Kashmir. I used to go repeatedly to Kashmir in the 90s when this fight was going on there. And the same people whom the Americans and the British and the Arabs and the Chinese were strongly supporting as liberals, I mean, you know, they used to talk about, you know, human rights and all that. These guys did not want minorities in Kashmir. Forget about Hindus or Buddhists. They didn't want Shia in Kashmir. They didn't believe people who are Sunni but not Wahhabi are Muslims. They did not want women to have any rights. They did not want anything called democracy. For them, democracy is the way it is now done, for example, in Saudi Arabia, Qatar, you know, Bahrain, very democratic countries. Very strongly supported by the West, all extremely democratic. That's the kind of democracy they wanted to have. So quite frankly, I mean, I've sometimes been a little, if I may say so, intemperate with my friends in Europe and America and all that, when they talk about the human rights situation in Kashmir, by supporting groups that want to completely extinguish all human rights in Kashmir. With all its defects, the state in India is not as bad as that. It's much better than that. So, from that point of view, I would say the Egyptian military is a force for a secular Egypt. The overwhelming majority of the Egyptian population wants a secular Egypt. And the advantage that we have got in Egypt now, after 1 year of Mohammed Morsi, the Egyptians clearly know what that kind of fanaticism means. after 2 years of Libya, the Syrian people are well aware as to what it means when NATO comes and liberates a country and gives it freedom and democracy from a dictator. They are well aware of what happens. I mean, I think we all know what's happening in Libya. Not too many people write about it. It's become a complete mess. So seeing that, the bulk of the Syrian people have remained with Mr. Assad. Assad has got a lot of bad points. He's his family is far too powerful and his administration is pretty awful. But at least if you go to Syria, women are allowed to wear what they like. You can dress the way you like, and there's an amazing amount of freedom there which is not there, for example, in Saudi Arabia or Bahrain or Qatar or even in Abu Dhabi, which are countries that are supposed to be the heart of the democratic alliance in the world. So from that point of view, young man, the Egyptian army is a force for a secular Egypt. And that is why the army has been given enormous support. It would not have got the support if Morsi had not been in power and if Morsi had not believed that, like what Erdogan did in about 6 years, he can do in 6 months. Erdogan did it in a creeping way. He got the European Union to support him against the Turkish military. He has taken a long time to make Turkey semi-Wahhabi. This man tried to do it in a very short period of time and got exposed. From that point of view, the Egyptian army is a secular army. And for me, I support secular people against religious fundamentalism of any kind.